REL Mid-Atlantic's School Discipline Alliance brings together state education agencies and other stakeholders in the region to support efforts to reduce and ultimately eliminate school discipline disparities. Multiple studies have shown that Black students and students with disabilities are more likely to be subjected to exclusionary disciplinary practices that compromise their opportunities to learn.
Exclusionary discipline is any action that removes or excludes a student from the classroom. This includes in-school suspension, out-of-school suspension, expulsion, law enforcement referrals, school-related arrests, and restraint and seclusion. A 2018 U.S. Government Accountability Office report found that Black students represented over 15% of all K-12 public school students, but 39% of students subjected to out-of-school suspension. In other words, Black students were overrepresented by roughly 23 percentage points. Similarly, students with disabilities represented 12% of the K-12 student population, but 25% of students subjected to out-of-school suspension. That is, they were overrepresented by roughly 13 percentage points.
A number of studies on discipline disparities have demonstrated the negative impacts of exclusionary discipline. For example, a study on the School District of Philadelphia conducted by Mathematica and the University of Pennsylvania found that out-of-school suspension decreases math and reading achievement for suspended students. Our alliance takes an evidence-based approach to reducing the use of exclusionary discipline and eliminating discipline disparities. Working with the Maryland State Department of Education, the priority for our alliance was co-developing a study to understand the extent of disproportionate discipline in Maryland.
We know that schools with disproportionate suspension and expulsion rates for certain groups of students, like African American or students with disabilities, is bad. We know that we need to remedy this, but first we need a good understanding of who these schools are and what their needs are. And that's what this project is about, and that's what we're really excited to learn.
Our project began with an analysis of Maryland public school discipline data to explore whether any racial or ethnic groups or students with disabilities experience disproportionately high removal rates. Mirroring national trends, Black students and students with disabilities attending Maryland public schools were suspended and expelled from school at disproportionately high rates, more than twice the rate of their peers. Even when they committed the same infraction in the same school, Black students and students with disabilities were more likely to be removed from the instructional setting.
Maryland is taking a number of steps to remedy discipline disparities, including providing technical support to school systems to help address root causes of disproportionate discipline and create a safe and supportive environment for all students, using research and data to identify supports schools might need to improve, and disseminating resources on social-emotional learning, preventative strategies, and alternatives to disciplinary removals. Moving forward, the REL supports MSDE as they consider the implications of the study. In addition, REL Mid-Atlantic will provide coaching and consultation to inform MSDE's next steps.
We're looking at the characteristics of schools that are identified as disproportionate in their disciplinary practices. Where are they located? What do they look like? Are they large or are they small? Are they homogeneous or heterogeneous? We take this information because we have a whole lot of resources and supports available for these schools, but we don't know where to target those resources and whether certain types of resources should go to schools with certain characteristics. And that's why this project is really important.
REL Mid-Atlantic is committed to connecting with educators in the field, listening to their needs, and working together to find solutions that are grounded in research. We're also committed to sharing what we're learning. So sign up for our newsletter, check out our website, check out the webinars and other activities we have going on, and let us know what you think.